Multiple sclerosis is a very common disease in young adults. It affects approximately 2.5 million people in the world. And the problem of multiple sclerosis is that it's the first cause of disability in young adults. We have about 10 to 15% of patients with a specific form of MS called primary progressive MS, where the neurodegenerative component predominates. And up to now, we have tried several drugs and several therapeutic strategies to modify the course of primary progressive with no success at all. Fortunately, in 2015, an important trial was presented at the ECTRIMS Congress here in Barcelona, where 9,000 neurologists participated, and showing that one drug, Ocrelizumab, which is an anti-CD20 molecule, improves and decreases the disability progression of patients with primary progressive MS, and also has an important effect on the MRI parameters. And up to now, as well, the good news is that we haven't seen very important side effects with this monoclonal antibody, and this opens a window of opportunity in the treatment of primary progressive MS. But not only in primary progressive MS, but also in other neurodegenerative diseases such as Parkinson's or Alzheimer's or others, where perhaps just fighting against inflammation at different stages could ameliorate the progression of the disease.